It's one of those events when the big boys of the financial industry engage in small talk, network, and enjoy good food and music. The reins of the Bankers Association of the Philippines were officially turned over to BDO Chief Nestor Tan from his brother, RCBC's Lorenzo Tan, who's now in the middle of an alleged money laundering controversy involving $81 million supposedly stolen from the Central Bank of Bangladesh. As Nestor, obviously in a light mood, made the rounds, his brother Lorenzo was nowhere in sight. We were told Lorenzo had attended the turnover ceremony but slipped out right after. Most of the things we've heard from Lorenzo's camp were from his lawyer, Francis Lim. Lim says his client calls claims by RCBC Jupiter branch manager Maya Deguito that Tan knew of the transactions, the remittance of bad money to several RCBC accounts, an outright lie. Lim adds Deguito's admission that she opened an account under the name of businessman William Go under the order of a certain Kim Wong is proof she violated bank rules and procedures. Go, for his part, made several clarifications on the issue as well. His lawyer, attorney Ramon Esguerra, says Go had met Maya Deguito first on February 22 and not 23 as earlier shared. Alan Peñalosa, manager of East West Bank where Go does his banking, supposedly asked him to meet up with Deguito, saying the conversation could get him no less than 200 million pesos. It was in that meeting that Deguito supposedly told Go she had opened an account under his name without his knowledge and asked for his help to close the account. The offer? 10 million pesos.
From what I understand, he asked Mrs. Deguito to clear his name from any involvement, and he may have asked for some form of damages in case that this case will drag on and involve him, implicate him. I mean, that's just not natural. There's no problem about that. The fact remains that there was a bogus account opened in the name of Mr. Go. That's the gist. I mean, the principal issue is that. Whether or not it's even a billion or 500 million or 10%, as you were saying, of the amount of $81 million, that's beside the point.
But Go said no. The next day, he supposedly met with Deguito again. Apologies were reiterated, so was the request to help close the bank account under his name. For a third time, a lawyer, a certain attorney Padas, whom the camp believes is with Deguito, met with Go at Manila Golf in an effort to persuade him to help close the account. After another unsuccessful attempt, a prominent businessman, allegedly called Go, made another offer, 20 million pesos. Go's camp also reiterates the businessman has no transactions then and now with PhilRem, the remittance company that handled a big chunk of the money. When ABS-CBN talked to PhilRem last week, it neither confirmed nor denied the issue. The company says it will not issue any statement for now so as not to preempt the Senate hearing on Tuesday. Michelle Long, ABS-CBN News.